They have planned a great air show for everybody here this afternoon. This morning and this afternoon. I got 45 minutes before I trust to start saying afternoon properly. So please, if you're wandering around the ramp anywhere today, there is no smoking on the ramp, and see someone smoking, please ask for them nicely to put that out. There are designated smoking areas at the backside of the ramp. I'm not sure where they are. But there is no smoking on the ramp. These airplanes have been filled with fuel. It could leak out. That's this shiny thing in the sky showed up this morning for us. It's going to expand the fuel inside the tanks. It may go out the overflow of the tanks of the aircraft. We don't want you to light a cigarette underneath the wing of the airplane. That's starting to fire because you're going to upset everybody on the ramp. We want the crash fire rescue crews to be able to just sit in their trucks all day long and just do nothing but watch the air show. They're ready to go if we have a problem, but we are not going to have a problem today. So they can sit in the truck, enjoy the show with the rest of us out there. So please, no smoking on the ramp. No big deal if you walk around and see a piece of garbage on the ground. If you've ever been to Oshkosh, Wisconsin, you will know that it's probably one of the cleanest air shows in the world. Bend over, pick up that piece of garbage, and deposit one of the garbage cans you'll see anywhere on the ramp today. Not a big deal. It makes the cleanup crew's job a whole lot easier. If you all go home today, they got to clean up after you.
We'd like to invite you to stop by and see the Disabled American Veterans Flight Team. They're here right now. Just look for the bright yellow DAV flags and the World War II B-25 bomber. The DAV has been helping veterans since the end of World War I and stands ready today to help you or your loved ones. Stop by today and see the B-25 at the Disabled American Veterans Flight Team.
I'm going to
Bill, please direct attention to the left where you can see two of the very own aircraft based right here at JBMDL, the KC-10 Extender and the C-17 Globemaster III. Now, these two aircraft will be departing. They departed from a while ago, entering from the left-hand side for us. This will be their demonstration pass. Now here comes air refueling formation from the left, again with the KC-10 extender leading the way. The KC-10 crew, the Air Defense Operations Support Squadron's formal training unit, is led by Major Marine Tanner from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. We got Captain Jamie Martinez from San Juan, Puerto Rico, and Major Mitch Erskine from Lakeville, Minnesota, along with Flight Engineer Technical Sergeant Chad Vickers from Mount Vernon, and the boom operator Master Sergeant Rick Dorsey from Lubbock, Texas. And behind them, back between about 150 to 150 high, is another air crew from the 305th Air Mobility Wing 6th Airlift Squadron. That's probably C-17 as Captain Jamie Lehman, from Greenville, South Carolina, along with Captain Stephanie Call from Chestertown, Maryland, Lieutenant Colonel Chad Anuzinka from Forest Lake, Minnesota, along with their loadmaster, Senior Airman Michael Carcano from Midgeville, Georgia. Now, normally these two giant aircraft connect at altitudes over 20,000 feet, but today they're going to pick a show center just above 2,000 feet for us. It gives us a close-up view here for the air show today. High overhead, the KC-10 and the C-17. Although the KC-10 serves primarily the AMC's premier air refueling asset, it is capable of refueling fighters while simultaneously carrying fighter support personnel and equipment overseas, transporting up to 75 people and nearly 170,000 pounds of cargo. In addition, the KC-10 has 6 fuel tanks, whose combined capacity of more than 356,000 pounds of fuel, almost twice that of the KC-135. Now, fuel is transferred to a receiver at a maximum rate of 1,100 gallons per minute, during which the advanced air refueling boom are more slowly through opposed to the probe system. Now, the additional KC-10 can be refueled by KC-135 or another KC-10 to increase its delivery range. With the capability of in-flight refueling, what you see demonstrated here today, the KC-10 enables the C-17 to deploy troops virtually anywhere in the world within a matter of hours. Now, the C-17 will be back later in the program that demonstrated salt landing for us. Now, the 1,100 gallons a minute, let's put it this way, folks. If you go over your Wawa fuel station out there, pull up that gas pump, stuck that hose in the gas tank, you would stand there for about almost 2 hours to pull that same amount of fuel. They're doing it in 1 minute. Again, General Eisenhower called the DC-3, the C-47, one of the top 5 weapons of World War II. It's a black Hyundai Sonata, New Jersey plate, uniform 80 Foxtrot Bravo Delta. That's again, that's a black Hyundai Sonata. If you brought your dog with you, you left it in the car. Yellow lot, was it? It's in the yellow lot. That's New Jersey plates, uniform 80 Foxtrot Bravo Delta. If you do not get back to the car in a couple of minutes and let it out, they're going to break the windows and let it out for you. So please get back to your car. If you're wandering around that ramp, stop on the Marine Corps recruiting tent where you can do a pull-up challenge or earn a prize. Now talk with recruiters and see if you have what it takes to earn the title Marine. That's about the Marine Corps.